But for pineapples, we are selling a seedling at what? At 200 shillings. But to plant an acre, you'll need 15,000 seedlings. So which translates to 3 million what? Mm-hmm. Shillings to be able to plant.
That's for 1 acre.
That is for 1 acre. So depending on the volume or number of acres that you'd want to plant, we can be able to provide you the seedlings. As I told you, I have another colleague I work with who is based in Masaka, where I sourced these ones. Because when we are giving out seedlings, we want to make sure that 15 months down the road, you are going to be smiling and remembering what we did for you.
Yeah. You know, I got someone asked me on my channel recently that can pineapple grow in northern Uganda? At first, I didn't know how to answer this question because I had not met you.
Yes.
But since you're here, I think you're the right person to answer that question.
Yes.
Can pineapple grow in northern Uganda?
Thank you so much, Chas. As you can attest to this, pineapples are doing very well in northern Uganda and can actually do very well, provided you have loamy soils. Even if they are sandy soils, you have just to avoid the swampy area, because pineapples don't need waterlogged soils, because then the root system will just end up rotting. They need significant amounts of rain when it is time to rain, but you don't have to plant them in a swampy area like eucalyptus. That eucalyptus type that needs a swampy area, it will just not thrive well. So here, as you can see, the soils are very rich generally in the northern sub-region. So unless I've not seen any area in the northern sub-region which cannot accommodate a pineapple grower.
Almost every area.
Yes, apart from a swamp.
Yeah.
You see?
Yes.
Which is more or less the same even if you went to another part of the country.
Uh-huh.
And just to interest people is that these ones are planted, of course, using suckers.
Oh, yeah.
Now, just to alert them that in an acre, you can actually plant 15,000 suckers.
Okay.
Now, 15,000 suckers, you use it when you're using a spacing of 1.5 feet from one sucker to the other within a particular line.
Oh, okay.
But from one line to the other, you just give it a spacing of 2 feet.
Oh.
So when you use that spacing, you'll be able to plant 15,000 suckers in a particular acre.
Wow.
Now, why we do it that way? Because of the nature of the soils, you want to make sure that you give the pineapples enough space. Remember, as I told you, once you harvest the first fruit, pineapples don't just die out there and then.
Yeah.
It will be able to grow other suckers that come from the ground.
So if you harvest one like this, more will still come from that.
Exactly.
Wow.
So depending on how the soil is fertile, you can either leave, it will give you up to 3 suckers. So you can either thin and say, I want only 1 or 2.
Yes.
But if you find that the soil is good and is adequate enough to handle the 3, leave all the 3 to grow well.
Yeah.
And that's why we give it a spacing of 1.5 feet from one to the other and 2 feet.
Yeah.
In areas where the soil is so exhausted and you know that whatever you do is not going to give you a very big fruit, that's when you use 1 foot for 1 foot by 1 foot to plant. There you have a lot of volumes, but it will be off some size, you see. But where you're sure that the soils are very good, please give it a spacing of 1.5 feet from within one line, and then from one line to the other 2 feet. Then it will be able to give you the size that you really want. Now, as I told you, as long as when you're weeding, just make sure you keep on putting soils along the pineapple lines, and so it will grow when it is having a lot of root penetration. That will give it a good anchoring and can give you a very good fruit, you see. And then there, you'll be able to see that once you remove this pineapple in a short while, the other suckers will start emerging that will give you the second fruit. If you look after the garden very well, by adding either cow dung, goat dung, rabbit dung, and cow urine and so forth, you'll harvest up to 4 times. But normally, we tell people that expect harvest up to 3 rounds. So this is going to be the first round of harvesting. Now, that takes 1.5 years. But the second round of harvesting, planting, you'll find you take wait between 11 and 12 months.
Oh,
why?
Okay.
Because the plant is already established, the root system is already there, the leaves are already there.
Yes.
So once the sucker comes from underneath, it is just feeding on this. So it's ready to move and it'll grow so fast.
Oh,
so that in 1 year, again, you find yourself picking another round of what? Of fruit.
Yeah.
As you continue looking after the garden, you continue adding the manure and feeding it, it will give you up to the third round.
Oh.
So imagine harvesting 15,000 pineapples, and after 1 year, you gain harvest 15,000 pineapples up to three times. And remember, these are pineapples that are not going to ripen at a go. That's the beauty of a pineapple garden.
Yeah.
1 acre, you'll find that it is ripening in phases. For instance, you can see we are harvesting this.
Yeah.
This one harvested some time back. You see now these leaves are quite grown.
Like three of them.
Yes, these are
four actually.
Yes,
wow.
These ones, they are more or less ready
so
to pick.
When was this harvested?
This one maybe was around May.
May, okay.
When we removed this one.
Wow.
You know, those are some of those early, because as you plant some of these leaves, there are those that are well grown, well developed, others are a little bit. So you find that when you plant, your pineapple will grow in phases. So imagine we harvested that one, but we can say we are really in earnest starting with these pineapples. So remember, there are those ones which are at this level, these ones which are flowering. Then you have these ones which are yet to flower. So as you keep on selling these ones, by the time you exhaust all these ripe ones, you will not realize it that this one is already almost time to ripen. Then you start harvesting. Before you realize harvesting that round and finishing that cycle, these ones will have flowered. So you'll keep on harvesting from a particular garden even up to 6 months. And that is weekly income, and that is very, very good for a farmer, especially in the region where people are used to planting, say, maize or soybean. And you find during harvesting time, a truck comes and moves in the region, in the villages buying. But because people are in need of finances because of school fees and so forth, they find themselves selling. In 1 month, you find the whole village doesn't have food. The money has been spent, which can be turned around by growing pineapple. Because pineapple, you keep on selling in phases. You see, it keeps on. And remember, by the time you finish the other one, because now we are getting this, before we finish a month or so, you are harvesting the other one, there will be this one. By the time you finish this one, this one will have brought another sack underneath. Before you realize it's already flowering. So you'll keep on having money for a long period of a minimum of 3 years. You see? And it's a very good crop that can be a game changer. And that's why I'm encouraging people to really look at this crop, provided you can get quality seedlings, which are we are able to what? To provide. Yes, please.
Someone may be asking, you've talked of suckers, that what is a sucker?
A sucker, I'm going to tell people there are three types. When you're growing pineapples, pineapples are grown vegetatively, meaning you get a part of a pineapple is what you plant to get another pineapple. And that one we do using suckers. Now for suckers, we have three types of vegetative growth on a pineapple. We have the crown, this very one. This one this whole thing
is called the crown.
When you pluck it off like this, you can break it off. You can actually plant this and get a pineapple. But this one will take you 2 years from the point you put it. 24 months for you to pick a fruit. Then we have the slips.
This
one,
like this.
Those ones take 20 months to be able to harvest. If they are well developed, 18 months. Then we have what they call the sucker. The sucker is when I told you that once you remove this fruit, there is the other suckers that grow from underneath. That you, if you're doing thinning, if you find that your garden is healthy enough and you don't have to thin, you don't have to touch. Those ones take 18 months. But when you go to a pineapple garden and people are selling you seedlings of pineapples or suckers, they are always referring to the slips. Those are the ones that are growing immediately underneath the pineapple. And that is what you plant and can be able to give you fruit.
You know what you're doing is actually quite amazing, and you went ahead up to a very far distance, I think over 400 kilometers
exactly,
to bring these pineapple seedlings here. And now the people from northern Uganda can just come and get it here, yes, even cheaply.
Yes.
So I know you are able to supply pineapple seedlings. You're able to people to do consultation, and people can learn from you.
Yes.
So how much someone who may be asking who wants to venture into pineapple farming? How much is a seedling for pineapple?
Exactly. Thank you so much. Here we are selling a seedling at 200 shillings.
Oh, only?
Yes, because actually I was in Igulu at some point,
yeah,
around the market, and I saw somebody trying to, I don't know where he sourced them from, and was trying to sell a seedling at 500. Oh. And I was saying, this is very unfair. Even if you have the crop, it's, if you are in to support the community, don't make it very expensive.
Exactly.
You see, make it affordable to the point that they can be able to. Of course, even if you're going to plant something, if you don't have money, even if it's a rice garden, it will be expensive for you.
Sure.
So, but for pineapples, we are selling a seedling at what? At 200 shillings. But to plant an acre, you'll need 15,000 seedlings. So, which translates to 3 million what? Shillings to be able to plant.
That's for 1 acre.
That is for 1 acre. So, depending on the volume or number of acres that you'd want to plant, we can be able to provide you the seedlings. As I told you, I have another colleague I work with who is based in Masaka, where I sourced these ones, because when we are giving out seedlings, we want to make sure that 15 months down the road, you are going to be smiling and remembering what we did for you. It's not good to just pick a seedling from wherever you're picking it from. You'll either end up with a sour pineapple. There are also pineapples, once it fruits like this, is not able to propagate and give you more slips to be able to harvest the second and third round. You harvest once and the garden is done. So there are different types of pineapples, and how you look after them that will determine how you can be able to get the crop. So this type of pineapple, we went at length to make sure that we avail it here. We want when it can be able to change, you know, the narrative in the north, where not necessarily that a humble community, a humble person, a humble household can sell off maize, and in 1 month the person is struggling again to survive. If they can be able to access these seedlings, even if you don't can't afford it as an individual, you team up and say we are three or four, and we want to buy an acre. Or if you're a farmer group or a VSLA or a saving group of some nature, you can collect money together and first start by growing gardens as a group. Remember, as I told you, once you harvest this crop, the slips that will come from out there will give you a minimum of 4 gardens, new gardens of pineapples. You see? And that's just the first round of harvest.
So the beauty about it is, if I come right now to Lard Mix Farm, then I buy 15,000 seedling, I may not be able to come back again, because I will already, you know,
exactly, be having it. That's what I want people to understand. When you buy your 15,000 seedlings and say you've bought an acre or two or three, depending on how fast you want to capture the market in the northern region, you'll buy the seedlings once and for all. From that point onwards, you are going to be a major supplier of seedlings to the nucleus community around you. And you can be able to mint money. Because, for instance, I told you, if you have taken an acre, and a minimum, remember, after the first round of harvest, it will give you 4 acres. If you want to just plant an additional one and remain with the mother garden, 1 acre plus another one, meaning you have seedlings for 3 acres that is available for selling. And that is only the first round of harvest. After 1 year, when you're doing another round of harvest, there will be seedlings worth another 4 acres. That one you can also sell up to the third round. And remember, by the time you are picking the third round of harvest in that mother garden, now the seedlings you planted after the first harvest, at that point they're also beginning to mature. And so you find yourself in a cycle of harvesting, you know. They say money grows on leaves. This is literally what I'm trying to tell people.
Yes.
Yes, please.
Wow.